I was born in Mexico City, Mexico in 2000. My mom was really young at the time. She was 16 or 17 when I was born. And my dad was around the same age. We were born into a really poor family, a poor environment. We lived in a little town outside of Mexico City. I came to the United States when I was 4 years old. We did enter unlawfully. I think we came in through Texas. We came straight to Rochester because my grandpa was here. I came not speaking a word of English. So I started preschool here and I just kind of learned English in school. But at the beginning, I remember my grandpa used to tell me stories about how I would sing to people to communicate with them and to make friends and stuff. But it was songs in Spanish, so nobody understood what I was saying. I was really excited to go to middle school just because it was like something different. I didn't have to be in one classroom the whole day. My sixth grade year, I was a straight A student. I did very well. I had a lot of friends. I was always overweight. I'm Hispanic, I eat tacos all the time. Like, that's my culture. I remember in the seventh grade, I had a crush on a boy and he told me I was fat. And him and his friends just like talked about it. People told me I was bigger before and it didn't bother me. And then for some reason, going into middle school, it started to bother me a lot. And it got to the point where I developed anorexia because I would stop eating. And when I did eat, I would throw it up. I was skipping school a lot. I didn't go to class. I would get dropped off by the bus and I would just leave. I wouldn't even go into the school. I had to get out of that hole. I had to pick myself up. In the seventh grade, my best friend went to a school called Golden Hill. She loved it there. So I wanted to go there too. I ended up going to ALC. Immediately my first day, it was like a complete 180 of my other school. Everybody was really accepting and I made a lot of really good friends there. The school is amazing. All the teachers are amazing. They're so helpful. They want you to succeed. I feel like every single teacher there, they're not just there because it's their job. They're there because they want to help you and they want you to do better and they want you to graduate. And it's just amazing because you can feel, as a student, you can feel when the teacher cares about you. When I was 15 years old, my mom told me about something called DACA, and that's deferred action for childhood arrivals. It gives us a work permit and it's a path towards citizenship. I have a license, I have a social security number, I can go to school anywhere I want to go. I can have almost all of the same rights that citizens have. Rochester is all that I know. So being threatened and getting told that I could be sent back to a place that I don't know is really scary. And that was just really heartbreaking more than anything. Because I didn't have a choice. I came when I was 4 years old. People still make comments and they still tell me that I shouldn't be here and that I should go back to my country, even though I'm here and I sound strong. I'm really a little girl. And my mom tells me that I have my grandpa's character and his strength. My strength also comes from my mom and my stepdad. I have been told that I'm really mature for my age. So that's kind of why. It's because I don't give myself a lot of wiggle room. to be a teenager, honestly. I have a goal, and I'm focused on my goal. I'm gonna be a nurse. I've always been so amazed with the human body. I know a lot of nurses, and I admire every single one because they're so nice and knowledgeable and smart. I wanna be a pediatric nurse because I love babies, and they're so cute. I wanna help people, I wanna heal people, I wanna be there when maybe they don't have anybody else. That's my goal right now, and I'm not letting go of that. I'm absolutely determined to reach it.